So you guys enjoy, and be thinking about the day that you're going to be standing up here. Just be thinking about that, because that's your motivation. That's what keeps you training every day. That's what keeps you coming to class when you're tired, and you don't feel like it, or when you want to do something else. That's what keeps you coming, this moment right here. This is the moment you're training for. You understand?
Yes!
Generations add to the life of their family.
And by adding, make it greater, not less. With dawn drawing light across the sky, I am Un-Bi. Invite you, my disciples, students, and family, to join me in a journey through our new day. Families need new generations to live. The spirit of Susun needs new enthusiasm and growth to be nourished in us. I am duty bound by the mantle of mastership to refresh tradition of spirit with knowledge and skills of our new age. A sage said, ages past, nothing new lies under the sun. Even in my bound duty to keep the ATA at the peak of this age, it is the technique and tradition of the ages. Only the patterns of their weaving are new. As given by that first master to your seniors, his disciples, I offer this new weave for your futures. Your senior, too, soon will be with you only in the weave and form created of their spirit for you. I dream that you learn to enjoy each day without thought to merely relive yesterday for its comforts, to climb the ladder of life or art. The security and warmth of the first step must give way to find a higher level. Witness with me this affirmation of our art, heritage, and renewal. In the spirit of Susun, I bring you Sangam to join the East and West, a new wellspring to mix and join in a voyage to the stars. Master Han Un-Bi, President and Founder, American Taekwondo Association. The scrolls.
All right, we come to another black belt ceremony. And the scroll of Sangam is our kind of a history, or kind of like how our Taekwondo began. And this past summer, or just a month ago, myself and Mrs. Hall and Ms. Bluth went to World Championships, and we went to the new headquarters. We got to see all the museums that they put together there, all the old photos and all the mementos and all the history of Sangam Taekwondo. So it's really cool to see that. So if next year in World Championships, I think it's going to be either June or July. I don't know the exact date of it yet. That might be an opportunity for you guys to go down to compete at World Championships, go to headquarters, and see the history. Because there's a lot of history, a lot of symbolism in our ceremony and in the scrolls that we do. And our art is formed on history and tradition. Okay. The gong that we use is a circle, and the circle is continuous, never ends. Okay, and that's what our Taekwondo training is supposed to be, never ending. Little did I know back in 1986 when I started that I would be doing this for the rest of my life. Okay, I didn't know I'd be doing it forever. Okay. I'm still doing it. Right, so it's continuous. The gong sounds 9 times slowly before we start, because 9 is a significant number in the Korean culture. It's 3 times 3. 3 is a significant number. That's why we do 3 bows and then 3 traditional bows. 3 times 3 is 9. We have 9 color belts. We have 9 degrees of black belt. The Sungam-1, the white belt form, is a factor of 9, 18 moves. The black belt form, first few form, is a factor of 9. 9 times 9 is 81. That's how many moves there is. Everything's based around that. Okay. The candle and the the candle in our ceremony is not is unique to our Grandmaster Hengun Lee, who started the UTA, when he came over to America, he got 2 gifts from his grandmaster. He got a candle and a bar of silk. What are these for? He just took them and came to America. So he started teaching Taekwondo to Americans, and the Korean government, they didn't like it. It wasn't supposed to be taught to Americans. It wasn't supposed to be to the Koreans. Just their little thing that was their private part of the daily. So he wasn't allowed to go back. He wasn't allowed to go back to Korea. And so he stayed here, developed the ATA, schools all across the country, other countries, masters everywhere. ATA is growing strong. We're now a major force in martial arts. So the Korean government, the consulate, the governing bodies of Taekwondo said, you know what? It's time for you to come back. You can come back to Korea now. So he went back to Korea and looked for his grandmaster and found out his grandmaster had passed away. He had no contact with anyone in Korea all this time. He didn't know. And so with his passing of the grandmaster also went the significance of the gift that he received. But it wasn't until years later that he realized and discovered what the gifts meant. The gifts meant sacrifice. Bar of soap sacrifices itself to cleanse the body. And that's what an instructor does. And, you know, when we cleanse the Taekwondo student's mind, you get your attitude right, you get your thinking straight, you get your discipline. That's what we do to Taekwondo instructors. Okay? The candle represents sacrifice because it gives up itself to light the way, to light the path, which is what a black belt does. Black belt lights the path for others to follow on their journey to black belt. Okay? So the most significant times in the student's life is when they get their first belt, orange belt. When they get their black belt, it's very, very, very special. And when they get that first mastership, that's very special. So I'm lighting the way for you guys, the black belts, to become masters. You guys are lighting the way for these guys to become black belts. This summer, I'm going to go back to Indiana, and I'm going to award one of my students their mastership belt. And they become masters this past year. Even though I have the first master, this past year I had my second master, and then next year I have another master. So I'm going to be presenting her belt to them when I'm back in Indiana. So it's sacrifice. We sacrifice for the benefit of the followers. So you guys have said, showed us the physical skills of a first degree black belt. Now I must ask if you accept the duties and responsibilities and the role of being a leader and a role model for the other students to black belt like yourselves. Okay? So, Ms. Abby, imagine you showed us the physical skills of a first degree black belt. Excited? Now I accept the duties and responsibilities of being a role model and a leader for the department.
Thank you.
would like to present to you. First, we'd like to Miss Abby Amen. And also, first, we'd like to Mr. Freedom Hutton.
Thomas first, I found a shock. I